Hey everybody, it's the Poltergeist 5000 back with more Earthbound. In the last episode, we made it to Saturn Valley, and in this episode, we're going to head for Grapefruit Falls. And we're gonna sit behind the waterfall, and we're gonna wait. Because that's what the Mr. Saturn told us to do. Now, there's a bit of a walk to get back there, which kind of stay lengths, but oh well. If I could walk in a straight line, that'd be nice. I'm bumping into the walls. Unfortunately, we do have to pass through this cave. No roaches, no roaches. No roaches, no roaches, no roaches. R-O-A, oaches, 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 roaches, raw! Anyway. People probably just run from this guy. What?! Okay, well, whatever. Let's just kick his ass then. Man, you attacking. Stop, what? Dodging. Man, what the heck? I'm off my game a bit today. I haven't recorded in like a week, which is the norm for this LP, but still weird. It's also like noon already because I took way longer. Okay, throat, you gotta stop that. I have toilet paper here. Maybe I could just blow by nose. Cause like seriously, I mean you can tell, right? I got a stuffy ass nose. Come on. I've never been good at that. Blowing my nose. I mean, I don't know how much it's really gonna help. Considering all the shit is, like, way further back. It's not even in my nose anymore. Ooh, nice. Okay, I just had a drink of, drink. Maybe that'll help. Anyway, here we are, back at Grapefruit Falls. Now, I didn't continue heading up here because there wouldn't have been anything to find, but now that we know the password, we can actually progress up here. Let's get that PSI freeze on that blue crocodile. That's pretty much the best way to deal with these guys. Oh yeah. Even that might be overkill. I don't know. Those crocodile enemies, like, watch out for them. Them and all their palette swaps, they're tough. I'm not sure what else you... I can only think of one other time you actually see crocodile enemies, though. That's weird, because I can only think of one other time when you see crocodiles, but I can see two different crocodile palette swaps in my head. That is so weird. Oh, no, you know what it is. That's what it is. When you eventually return to the... No, here we go. Say the password. Okay, so now we just sit here and don't do anything for 3 minutes, so I'll just keep talking about what I was talking about. When you return to the caves in Winters, just north of Stonehenge, to get the sanctuary location there, there are crocodiles in there that are, like, blue, and then later on you find crocodiles that are, like, pink. Like, way later. So, yep, just waiting, I guess I could... What can I even talk about? Recording? Like, do I have any plans? Well, I had a weird plan. I've been playing a little bit of Roller Coaster Tycoon recently. And I was thinking of actually trying and seeing if I could record a video on that, because I got OpenRCT 2, which includes a fast forward option, which would allow me to fast forward through all the parts, like in game, without needing to edit anything. I could fast forward through parts where I'm just waiting for money to come in. So, maybe look forward to that. Maybe I'll, like, upload that this Saturday. Like, that'll be my Saturday thing. I don't fucking know. I keep acting like I have these things, but but the only LP I'm even remotely keeping up on is Earthbound. I keep saying I'm gonna get back to Majora's Mask, but... I mean, geez, man. You know what the worst part is about Majora's Mask is that I left off in the middle of a temple. Like... If I pick it up, I'm gonna be in the middle of a temple. And I already restarted the temple once because the break was so long between the episodes. I can't do it again. Stone Tower Temple, the temple that just wouldn't die. I mean, I guess that could make for a pretty interesting, if not interesting, at least funny, way to kind of artificially extend the LP, but... I mean, there's gonna be so much bullshit at the end of the LP of me doing side quests anyway. Like Anju and Cafe, I mean, that's gonna take its own episode. Or even more than that if I decide to do it alongside anything else. Not to mention you have to do that fucking side quest twice! Because you have, because there's a fork in the path. And one way lets you finish it, and the other way lets you get a hat, but you have to do it twice. Like, jeez, man. I mean, I don't know, like, what other heart pieces am I even missing in that game? There's the one that I've been looking for in, like, several loops now, but I can't find. It's the one where you have to play songs for the gossip stones in the caves, but I can never finish it because I can never find all the fucking caves. Because the holes don't appear, they don't render properly on the emulator I'm using, so I can't tell where they are when I'm actually near them. I'm just, like, awkwardly fumbling around where I'm pretty sure there is a cave. But how the hell am I supposed to know, you know? Fuck. Has it really not been 3 minutes yet? Okay, there we go. Okay, you may enter. Fucking finally. Okay, here we are. Oh, I love the music in here. This music is actually a remix of a song from Earthbound Zero, Beginnings, Mother One, whatever the fuck. It sounds really weird in this. I've been noticing that, like, when you come into the menu and you move between the person's inventories, like, it goes. But it's supposed to be a lot sharper than that. It's supposed to be like, tow, tow, tow. Not just, boom, boom. I don't know, whatever. You bring some fly honey? It's Master Belch's favorite. Yeah. Okay, you may pass through. Oh, gosh. Hey, be careful. Be sure you don't drop it. Yeah, I won't. What the heck is this? It's a red, and I'm scared. A Foppie, and its cohort. And its cohort is also a Foppie. That's pretty goofy. These things are really, really weak, but they give a fuckload of experience. And I think they can drop PSI caramels. Whatever the case may be, they're really good for grind. This is a really good place to grind in the game if you want. If you want to grind, this is the place to do it. Now, I probably would, but unfortunately, this has kind of landed at an awkward time. I'm probably gonna make it through all the way through this base in one episode. And because of that, I'm not really gonna have a chance to grind in here, because I would want to do that off-screen, you know, like how I did that in Winters. I extended the episode a little bit longer to get the last cutscene in so that I could grind in Stonehenge. Oh no, farm zombies. Let's try PSI Fire Beta. I think these guys are weak to PSI Fire. And how about a Bob? A Bob on B, because it's got splash damage. It's got stab damage because it's a normal type. Anyway. Well, that actually, oh man, I wish he hadn't wasted that bomb on just one guy. Jeez, fish. Could have done like 10 more damage there, 20 more damage, something. What's in here? There is a bomb. Oh, well, there you go. Never mind. I'm glad I used that now because we wouldn't have had the inventory space otherwise. Oh, man. This is like grade A cutout material, but I don't want to cut shit out if I don't need to. Because, like, I need to upload this episode as soon as I'm done recording. So, I can't afford to have stuff I need to edit. You know. But whatever. Ooh, offensive alpha. That's mediocre in this game, at best. Without combos, without Mother 3's combo system, holy crap, is that 7? No, it's just 6. Without combos, like Mother 3 has, there's really not as much impetus to actually increase your physical attack power, except for, like, well, I mean, because Tyke, Kyle, and, what are their name last guy, John? Like, they don't have as much PSI damage potential. Kyle's got his gadgets. Well, actually, everybody has other damage potential, but the thing is, attacking is free. But that's the only thing. That's the only thing that attacking has over PSI in this game, is that you don't have to spend anything for it. Otherwise, PSI is, in all shades, just a smarter option. Which means that increasing your offense isn't isn't nearly as important as it is in Mother 3, and therefore, Offensive Alpha is not nearly as useful. There you go. Did I say that succinctly enough? Holy shit. Now, I'm not really worried about conserving my PSI, because I'm pretty sure... Oh, man, I wish you hadn't done that first. Because I'm pretty sure, there's a room in here that always gives you a magic butterfly. What? He did something very mysterious. These guys' pants are so stupid. Like, they're just wearing, like, boxer shorts. It's ridiculous. Which reminds me of the Earthbound Halloween hack. You spend the first half of the game chasing after this, like, horrible monster as a bounty hunter. Because, like, you've been hired to do that. When you finally encounter the monster, it's a horrifying, hideous creature. But it still has, like, it still wears a goofy pair of underwear. It's just hilarious. Have any of us taken any damage at all? I don't think we've taken any damage at all. Get rid of the protractor. The protractor. I was trying to come up with a joke about that, but I couldn't think of it fast enough. I'm gonna... Now, see, here's the thing. These IQ capsules, they increase IQ, you know, whatever. Most people give these to Kyle because his IQ determines what he can fix. But the thing is, he's gonna naturally get enough IQ to fix everything he can fix in the game anyway. You don't need to use any IQ capsules on Kyle, it's a waste. What I usually do is give them to Fish, because IQ promotes PP growth. Ooh, a broken laser. A secret mission. Happy now? Yes. I don't really need the broken spray can. Yeah. The broken spray cans, they're like one of the only fixable items you can actually buy. But the reason you can buy them is because the item that Kyle fixes them into is gone after one use. So it's pretty mediocre. Ah! So honest! Smile, boing. No problem here. What are they doing? Like, they got them chained up, they're like packaging fly honey or something. Tired, but so good. Bing. What are you guys doing? Master Belch is the slimiest. However, I already also serving some Gygas guy. That I cannot believe. It's hard to make the gross sounds that Master Belch does. I know I can't do it. Well, you're on your way. Oh no! Oh my gosh! Flies. Slimy little pile. These guys are really annoying too. They can do the same thing I mentioned before where they'll... You know, I think I'm just gonna bust up PSI games. You can kiss my butt. They do the same thing I was mentioning before where they'll like... burp and blow nauseating breath at you and like everybody will start crying. So annoying. This should kill the mostly rotten flies in the back. I hope. Yeah, that ought to do it. Yeah, no problem. No problem. I got that for crying. Why? This should end it. Oh yeah. Yeah. The good thing about crying is that it goes... Yeah, at least crying goes away at the end of a battle. You don't have to worry about it, like... Oh, you're an enemy? Okay. I thought you'd be a guy, but no, you're just an enemy. You're an entity. Oh, you're dead already. That was easy. I did not expect you to die in one hit. It's so weird how some enemy, how like, the slimy little piles, some of them will talk to you, some of them just straight up attack you for no fucking reason. Oh, you're just gonna be here. So you're the ones who destroyed them that I had to three. Oh no! We didn't really destroy them, we just trapped them. Like, jeez, man. This music is so good. That's, I think that's just called Battle Against Belch, but it plays against all pukey enemies. He must be really pukey. Nope, fish leveled up and learned nothing. Whoop-a-dee-doo. Well, whoop-a-dee-doo, here come those idiots now. Yeah, here we go. This is what I was saving those insecticide sprays for. I'm pretty sure these guys, you always encounter a bunch of these guys in this room. I mean, it's a pretty whatever thing to save an item for. It's like, I gotta make sure I have this. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to beat him otherwise. Oh no. You don't one-shot. Oh my gosh. Holy fucking ass. That was a lot of damage. No, I didn't. Nar. Durr. Okay, I should have followed that up with a PSI fire, at least. Seriously. Let's, you defend, actually, because you're hurting. And I don't want you to die. There you go. Wait, those guys use that music too, huh? I don't know. It's just kind of like it's a really droomy battle theme. Ooh, a vital capsule. I'm gonna give that to fish too, because vital capsules increase your vitality, which promotes HP growth. And fish is gonna be the one with the lowest. Ooh, damn! An HP sucker. Radical, bro. That's great. That's an item for Kyle. That's gonna be really handy. Like, especially in this exact instance. Because what that'll do is it'll damage an enemy, but it'll also heal him. It usually won't be quite as powerful as, like, just, attacking. But the fact that it heals, I usually just you do nothing but use the HP sucker, because it's just that useful. Ding 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 do 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 do. So bad at singing. Later on, you get an upgraded version of that HP sucker that actually attacks all. That actually affects all enemies, which is just so nice. Yeah. Man, you crying? You shriek? If I can just do that again. And then you can just use the HP sucker again. On the slimy little pile, because he's got the most HP of anybody in this battle. Yeah, that guy's dead, but that guy still needs a little bit more doing. What? Yeah, that's the only unfortunate thing, is that sometimes it just flat out won't work. I don't know what it is. Sometimes it feels like the success rate goes down every time you successfully use it on an enemy. Like maybe you're only supposed to what? Huh? No. How could you do this? Okay, well whatever. Let's use PSI freeze beta, and then you, on the off chance that you decide to go first, there you go. This should work on him now. What? Well, fine. Fucking asshole. Now let's get out of here. I don't want to fight you butt-munch-ass-munch-ass-butts. There's too many of them. I just want to get to the... I know there's a fucking... There's a door, like, 2 steps to the left. That has a magic butterfly in it. I just know it. And that's the last of Fish's PP, so we better get over there. Because this is going to be bad if we don't have any PSI to help ourselves. I might actually not make it all the way through here in one episode. That'd actually be nice if that happened, because I could take a little bit of time to grind off screen, but I probably won't, because I'd have to walk back through the dungeon and then walk back through it again to get back to the end of it. Oh, come on. This is the room. Just sometimes it won't. Sometimes a butterfly won't appear. Yeah, man. For how much of a pain in the ass this area has been, we've like been breezing through it. Like we've barely taken any damage at all, aside from that smash hit. I could probably make it through the rest of the dungeon with just this. Because you don't need any PP for the boss. This is like... This boss is almost a cutscene boss. It's that easy. We'll get to that when it happens. It's gonna blow your fucking mind. I might actually just record the one episode today, because I gotta get this out soon. And also, I've got breakfast here that I haven't finished eating yet. And there are important matters that require my... Whatever. I couldn't think of a word. That require my... Not expertise. Hell no. But whatever. Anyway. So I think I'm just going to record the one episode, and then I'll record the rest of this week's episodes tomorrow. Or just later. I'm also feeling a little bit physically ill, which kind of stinks, but oh well. Another one. The epilogue. I'm gonna bust out a bottle rocket. Kiss my butt. Cause I'm not gonna need it for the boss. Oh, I didn't actually kill him. What do you know? What? No, not a second one! Oh, man. How many of these assholes we got on the ship, anyway? These guys are little frowns for some reason. Oh, my gosh. Again? I just healed that, like, 10 minutes ago, in-game. Final spy. Yeah, he's dead, though. Whatever. I literally just healed that when I got to Saturn Valley, and now you're homesick again? I mean, seriously, man. Hello, senor. Aren't you the Lionel delivery boy? What's the password? It doesn't mean I don't trust you. Just say it. Say it now! Someone's so quiet, it's either extremely tired or extremely dangerous. What a suspicious fellow! What? Come on, you know what the password is, you dumbass! You Alexandria dumbass! Wow, I really didn't need to be like... Oh, fuck. Okay, well, there you go. I was going to say I really didn't need to be using PSI on all these guys, because they were pretty slow, but then... Oh, well, there you go. Okay, we get... Yeah, you just did that. I can't get that burp sound. Something like that. There you go, you died. You died. You died. Ooh, he left a bomb. Cool. I didn't know those guys dropped prezzies. Oh, son of a fuck. Man, what a pain in the ass. Okay, let's just bust out because I gave some beta. You guys can kiss my ass. Kiss my ass. Kiss my ass. Jeez. Yeah. What the hell was that? 107 damage. That's nothing. That's a cock-a-tripe, man. Jeez. 107 damage. Give me a break. I can't believe it. Don't say that. I love... There's a quote from Final Fantasy X that I love saying whenever I say I can't believe it or whatever. But it's such a huge spoiler for that game. I don't want to say it. Oh, there he is. The Belch Master himself. What do you guys hear? This is absolutely ridiculous. You'll never believe what's about to happen here. It is so stupid. Here we go. Burr! So you are Tyke. I see. York, York, York! There's a prophecy that we all know it's from Master Gygus. You make me laugh so hard. If Master Gygus is scared of someone, you have any worse than the greatest evil. Gar, 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 gar. I'll take you out big time so get ready for the worst fight of your life. Burr! Gar, gar, gar. You already feel the pain of true nausea. Burr! Yeah, come on, let's go! Jeez, what a crazy man. This is Master Belch, just even if I didn't get any worse. How nasty is that, right? Like, that is disgusting. Now, the thing about this fight is that it is completely impossible to win this unless you use the fly honey. Actually, that's not true. But I'll explain why in a second here. Basically, unless you give him the fly honey, he'll heal all damage you do to him instantaneously. And you won't be able to do anything. I'm gonna use a sudden guts pill. Like this right here. That was a waste because it didn't actually accomplish anything. Burp. Okay. Oh man, he just burped on fish. So I gave him the fly honey, and now he's grabbed the fly honey. And from here on out, he's not gonna do anything for the entire battle. He's gonna be completely ineffectual. The only threat is that nausea that he gets on you right at the beginning of battle. But the thing is, there actually is a way to beat this guy without using the fly honey. Oh, for fuck's sake. Ugh, fish, how about you just use the refreshing herb next time? Ah, nice, lovely. Okay, yeah, how about you just use the refreshing herb this turn, because I know you got one. Because apparently Tyke is too much of a piece of shit. Apparently the body human is too stupid to realize it needs air. Open those fucking things up. Anyway, Master Belch lost his mind by wolfing down fly honey. There's something so weird about that. Like, he lost his mind, like he just did. What about last time? Did he not really lose his mind then? It's not present tense, it's past tense. Like it should be Master Belch loses his mind wolfing down fly honey, not lost his mind. That's weird, man. But yeah, if you actually use the HP sucker, he won't heal the damage that it deals, for some reason. But only the HP sucker has that effect. I can't for the life of you tell... I couldn't for the life of me tell you why that's the only thing that can actually damage him. But anyway, there you go. No problem. Stretch. Ooh, Hypnosis Omega. That's... alright.
Burp! Let's see what you're gonna fight. Burp!
But Master Agus has managed to get the money Molly's taking to Foresight. Burp! The city will soon be in worse condition than living in your own puke!
Suffer, Spanky! Burp!
Amazing. Next time on Earthbound, we will leave this place and see where it takes us. Bye!